On February 20th, an FDA...
...for a close encounter with raw nature as you've never seen it before. Violent footage shows you the thrill of the hunt and the strategy of the kill. The relentless drive to continue the bloodline and the miracle of birth.
I looked in, I saw in trouble.
Hey, way to blow, Mama!
I took a little touch and...
Mama!
Ah! Oh, my God! Rory! You son of a bitch! What have you done to me?
Now look, calm down!
Oh,
no!
Don't panic!
Calm down! I'm standing here with my dog in my hand.
Your dog, look!
Oh, thank God, it's just a chain hanger. Ready? Still here.
A Dutch scientist invented a storage jar for electricity in this...
This is the elaboration of the nth degree.
Prodigal son dancing for Balanchine in a world of pain and magic.
Going around with our programming, turning it inside out, upside down. Even pick out as many mistakes as you can. Put them on a postcard and send them to Comedy Central. If your card is one of the 100 we pick, you'll win some great dance sport outdoor gear. Spend April 1st as foolishly as possible. Collect the mistakes during What's Wrong With This Channel all day.
Only a replica survives. It may seem surprising that such an artist could have painted for the great American cities. But where his theme was the power of the machine and the marvels of technology, he overrode political opposition earlier in the 30s. His populist realism and a strong traditional sense of compositional order appealed directly to the widest of publics in the States as well as Mexico. Rivera's art corresponded to a notion of revolution and social realism. Elsewhere, in Europe, another revolution was taking place, led by a poet who saw himself so much as a revolutionary that he traveled to Mexico to visit Rivera and Trotsky, André Breton. The surrealist revolution also emerged as a reaction to the abstract aspects of modernism. For the surrealists, art opened a route to the marvelous, or the surreal.
This is René Magritte's Le Double Secret, painted in 1927. The surrealists understood, perhaps better than any group, that man is like an iceberg, of which only a small part is visible in the light of the conscious mind, the rest of which is submerged and moved and guided by the darker currents of the human subconscious. The problem was how to find ways into the subconscious, how to release the spontaneous flow of imagery and writing that would be as unsettling as the chance encounter of an umbrella and a sewing machine on a dissecting table. André Breton advocated two routes into the marvelous, to dream and automatism. Influenced by psychoanalytical theory, Breton decreed that subconscious images could only become available if the oppressive control of reason was evaded. The transcription of dreams attracted the so-called painter painters, such as René Magritte and Salvador Dali. Dali's painting, Soft Construction with Boiled Beans, a premonition of civil war,
seems to embody his ambition to visualize images of complete irrationality with incredible precision. Through his highly naturalistic style, Dali gives a sense of reality to images that are unreal, inspired by nightmares and visions. The second kind of surrealist artist, the painter-poet, is exemplified by the sculptor Alexander Calder and the painters Joan Miró and Max Ernst. Using poetic techniques of free association.
He's so cool. He's so warm. He's so hot.
It all started in 1983 when giant posters like this one started popping up all over Hollywood. There was no advertising attached except for a name and a couple of pointers.
I lay down for one to send. I'm the first and a seven.
I met Johnny at a party last night. He's just a playboy, but that's all right.
Sonny boy! Where are you, Sonny boy?
You better bug out, baby.
Ah, there you are, boy. You know you're not gonna learn how to be a rooster by playing out back of the hen house.
But its effect as a political statement by a modernist against blind cruelty of those who claim to stand for civilization was instant.
In 1937, an exhibition of so-called degenerate art opened in Munich. It was organized by the Nazis to demonstrate the thoroughly Jewish, Bolshevik, and anti-Aryan nature of modern art.
Oh, what? I come back for 1 minute, what? That was never! Oh, we did it 1 minute 7. Oh, I don't believe that. The clock was rigged.
No, Michael, I have 1 minute 28 seconds.
What do you mean?
Yeah, I just...
No, that was Korea. The prosecution is asking...
And move into your own cozy little love nest. Plenty of extra closet space. Perfect for entertaining. And on those chilly winter nights, Sally can wrap herself up in this cover. And on those hot summer nights, she can wrap herself up in ice. It's all yours, Tommy, if you play ball.
What do you say?
Hey, I'll see you behind bars.
Creating a birthday today, actress Sarah Jessica Parker is 27. Actress Bonnie Bedelia is 44. Singer Elton John is 45 today. Singer Aretha Franklin turns 50. Singer Hoyt Axton is 54. And sportscaster Howard Cosell is 74.
What we're looking at is a Democratic Party that is has good news and bad news. The good news is the old losing liberal coalition is gone. The bad news is they have nothing left to replace it.
You explain that to me. I don't quite follow it.
You've got Labor divided. You've got...
Labor said they're going to rally around him in the fall.
That's their leadership.
And
when you get the rank and file... The rank and file voters in Labor will still provide...
In all these developments we've traced, through cubism, abstraction, surrealism, to the cosmic visions of Malevich and Kandinsky, we are asked to look not to the past, but to the future. As Miro put it, to open a door to a different future, free of all hypocrisy and fanaticism.
Paul Tsongas, who suspended his financially troubled campaign last week, took 20% of the vote. Now, the Republicans still has amassed nearly...
They know it's a shock. It's jive. They're not going to do anything.
Change their minds about that?
You need a revolution. You need a radical change. To take back power and...
Bert Walter pays securities funds, capital growth funds, and money market funds.
Okay.
kind of rusty. Haven't practiced.
Hooked up, or excuse me, they inserted the darts into the clothing of my...
New York, there's a show of thieves at the Met. These are Chinese ceramics.
Right, right. Ming is a part of that.
Yeah, and is it safe or fair to ask you what these things, the price of them?
Well, I usually don't like to talk about the value of things because people start looking at something and they're only looking at what it's worth. You know, like a great painting, oh, it's worth $4 million or something. So I just like to, I just say they start around $300,000 and can go to $1 million or even two.
$2 million?
That's unbelievable. Yeah, they're going back. For example, this piece back.